Hello, my name is Beth Ann Santangelo, and I'm doing my persuasive speech. The topic that I've chosen to discuss is the topic of mandatory drug testing in high school. As a parent and as a nurse, I can tell you that early detection of teens using drugs will help them in adulthood. They will be less likely to have drug problems in adulthood if early detection during high school is achieved. A positive drug test. First of all, a student, if they're not doing drugs, shouldn't be afraid to do a drug test because, as we all know in society, drugs are not tolerated, right? So we have these students that are 8th, 10th, 12th grade doing drugs and they think they're getting away with it. And then what happens is they become adults and they still think they're getting away with it. But as an adult, you're losing your job, you're losing your license, you're going to jail. What we need to do is find these teens that are doing these drugs and change their behavior when they're teenagers. And it will make it a lot easier to avoid a lifelong use of drugs. With this being said, I can tell you that there's about maybe 1,000 schools around the country that actually mandatory drug testing. This is according to the Upfront news magazine for teens out of the New York Times. Other than that, the only drug testing that we are able to do to students is actually to student athletes. Back in 2002, the Supreme Court sanctioned that schools can drug test all students that are in that are high school athletes, and that of course if there's suspicion of drugs. The funny thing is that these students that are in athletics really don't have as much time to do drugs, I would think, as the students that don't do athletics. I mean, the students that don't do athletics have all day after school to go and do whatever they want to do, whereas the athletes are actually running or on the field or doing healthy kind of things for their body. So basically, there is a no tolerance rule in society for drugs. If you work at McDonald's, you get drug tested. If you work at Boeing, the helicopter industry, they drug test. If you work at a hospital, you're drug tested. But if you go to school in high school, you're not drug tested. The problem being with this is 28.4% of 8th, 10th, 12th graders, it was declared in the 2013 Monitoring of the Future study done by the National Institute on Drug Abuse. So 28.4% of these students in 8th, 10th, and 12th grade were doing drugs, basically. They did a study. So now, these students, you know, they're not doing the kind of drugs that they did back in the 60s and 70s. Now they're doing prescription drugs. They're doing opiates. Of course, they're smoking marijuana because it's on the verge of being legal, but it's still illegal. And, of course, the worst drug that's very accessible in this day and age is heroin. So these students are using these drugs, and what it can do to them as, you know, these young brains are developing is it can lead to short and long-term effects. Short-term effects is basically poor performance in school. You know, unrisky behavior. Well, as a teenager, you're already taking risks, right? So you add a drug into it and it's just that much more. Then as it leads into dependence, it can learn to, it can lean into crime, it can learn lead into all kinds of things that will end them in jail, basically. Mood changes, depression, anxiety, paranoia, psychosis, all these are problems that are worsened by drugs or brought on by drugs. So then these students, you know, they're acting out. So then we send them to a psychiatrist and or to a psychologist to try to sort out their mood problems, when actually the mood problem may be resulting of a drug-induced somewhat side effect. My idea is that we drug test them all, right across the board. So then we're not saying, okay, look, this one did it, and we think this one did, and we think... No, everyone gets drug tested. If you come back positive, then we can change their behavior. We can start their therapy early. The opposition, which they say, oh, drug testing's too expensive. Well, I can tell you that drug abuse is way more expensive as you get older. There's the option of overdosing. So then we're going to have to pay for hospital visits, all kinds of life support. Who knows? It could be for the rest of your life as a vegetable, depending on what, how far out in your drug use that you've been found unresponsive on the streets. So the deal is that you find these children early. We change their behaviors. We identify the users. We start early coping mechanisms. We drug test these students more frequently after we find that they had an initial positive drug test. And the bottom line is we try to prevent teenagers from addiction. We'll improve learning. We'll decrease crime. We'll stop this poor academic performance that's coming from these students that are using drugs. And in the future, as adulthood comes along, they'll be able to hold a job. They're not going to fail drug tests. They're not going to not go to work. They're going to, they'll be able to hold down a job. They'll be responsible and accountable for their actions, which now the students aren't. Oh, Johnny told me to do it. Oh, I was with this one. And you know what? That doesn't fly as we get older. And these students now need to do it. So the opposition, which is the ACLU, it's the Anti-Civil Liberties Union, their big problem that they bring up all the time is the problem of the Fourth Amendment, which says that, you know, you don't have the right to be searched and seized, and that we have the right to privacy. All true and fair, but as a student that's on drugs, that leads into adulthood, that right to privacy, you lose it. If you're an adult and you're not at work because you failed your drug test, your privacy's lost anyway, because you're not going to be able to work. You know, I mean, the right to privacy is true, but as an adult with a problem with drug abuse, you'll lose all your rights. So we need to teach them as teenagers that to have rights, you need to be accountable and responsible. And this is a big part of it. In the 2000 National Household Survey on Drug Abuse, it revealed that 4.5 million people aged 12 and older who needed treatment, 23% were teenagers. That's a quarter of all the people. They were teenagers that already had these drug abuse problems. So, I mean, we have this war on drugs campaign. We have the, you know, oh, pass out the pamphlet and say no to drugs. But then what happens on a Friday night when they all go out and they're all together and you have this one person that's older brother is into drugs, so then they're passing the drugs down to the younger ones. They're doing the drugs. And the problem being then all the other kids are doing the drugs. So the cycle needs to be stopped. And the big part to stopping this cycle is by mandatory drug testing in high school. then we'll be able to identify who did it, and we'll be able to come up with a plan to help these children cope. I will tell you that according to the scales here in Yamaguchi's paper, they compared no drug testing and drug testing students in three different models. The models that they did drug testing with, between 20 to 23% were doing illicit drugs. And the ones that no drug testing were done, 17%. So you're talking a difference between 3 to 4% of these students are declared as doing drugs, they found on this study. So my point is, okay, it's not double digits, but it's still 3 to 4% that these drug tests are showing that these children are doing drugs. So we need to be, you know, this is a big percentage, because one life can change a lot to a whole family. And oftentimes in our society, all the parents are working, things cost so much money, there's a lot more latchkey kids. I will tell you that my son, an honor roll student, all of a sudden his grades were dripping down, and I immediately, as a nurse, thought, I wonder why this is happening. I wonder if he's doing drugs. I will tell you that he barely goes out. So the only place that he does go all the time is school. It's a central meeting place for all socioeconomic backgrounds, people of all different behavioral styles. And it's easy for a kid to get hooked up with someone that has negative problems with drugs. So early detection, and if the schools and the parents work together to detect these children that are on drugs, then we can treat them. The cost of a drug test is around $40. The cost of therapy for drugs can lead into millions, depending on, you know, needed of hospitalization, follow-up treatments, follow-up drug testing, and this sort of thing. So I think that mandatory drug testing would work, and I urge all parents to think of this, and it would be a black and white, yes, here it is, it's right in the cup, and we will be able to intervene early and help these students so that they'll have solid work ethics before they get into work and have to deal with these demons that are brought in from being connected with drugs. I will leave you with this. There's a pamphlet from the Office of the National Drug Control Policy. It's easily attainable online. It's drug testing in schools. It tells you all about different kinds of things related to drug testing. Also gives you all kinds of websites that you can go to find for drug help. My point is, come out of the dark and show the light. The light is this. The light is, we need to be able to identify these students, and mandatory drug testing will show us who's doing it, and we will be able to intervene at an early age. Thank you.